So now to get started on the content for the day, I'd like to introduce the Prime Minister. Well, you already know him. I'd like to welcome the Prime Minister, Mr. Kary Mesimov, and ask him to give his opening remarks.
Dear ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests and participants, it's a great pleasure to welcome you today at the Kazakhstan Investment Summit held at the outset of the Astana Economic Forum 2016. It has been almost a decade since the start of the global financial crisis, but the downside economic risks not only persist but threaten to worsen. These risks jeopardize all countries, but especially emerging markets. From year to year, we see an increasing number of countries which had been successful, see their economies stagnate, or worse, actually decline. What is truly alarming is that, in some cases, these countries threaten to become failed states, with heightened instability and loss of accumulating achievements becoming a threat to the entire world. In Kazakhstan, we have always wanted to be as flexible as possible. We look around us, study our environment, seek to anticipate possible negative trends, and try to adapt to such challenges. Since the beginning of 2000, we have experienced sharp economic growth, which translated into a huge increase in welfare of the nation. This has created increased expectation about further steps towards greater economic prosperity. As the Kazakhstan economy has slowed, we have had a legitimate concern that one day our country could face increased populism and be a victim of division in society. We wanted to anticipate these threats. What could we do about this? First of all, it is always important to get the right people into the state apparatus. We need to minimize conflicts of interest. The civil service is supposed to be embedded in society so they understand the problems that the country faces and can effectively serve the people. The judicial system has to guarantee that all are equality under the law. This will allow a transition to a more rule-based development state and greater trust in the state. The idea is to develop institutions which would channel popular pressure to pressure the state to work better without risking disruptive populism or conflicts. An important element of achieving this and would be to promote transparency and accountability of the state, including judiciary and legislative power at all levels. Our strategy was to introduce meritocracy as a universal principle for the entire public sector, including the courts, law enforcement agencies, national companies, and holdings. Guided by these ideas, last year we launched a set of unprecedented institutional reforms, probably the largest since the independence of Kazakhstan. Moreover, we decided to support these institutional reforms by making major structural shifts in the economy with a focus on large-scale privatization, market liberalization, and removal of price control. All these reforms were launched last year by the President Nursultan Nazarbayev under the Plan of Nation, the 100-step program. Such a move demonstrates a strong political will and a commitment to create a country that will ensure a good life for all our citizens. I look forward to your support in helping the country achieve this essential goal. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Prime Minister. Some very interesting context there for for the situation Kazakhstan is in today. I mean, some things I found interesting to note particularly was the what the Prime Minister mentioned about the need for Kazakhstan to be flexible in adapting to the changing circumstances, making sure that the country keeps social harmony, and his concerns about populism and division. Those are trends that we're seeing actually in many countries around the world now, not just in Kazakhstan. And finally, the big reforms last year, how big will the impact of them be, and what needs to come next? So some more points for us to touch on during the rest of the day. For our next session, I'm very pleased to be able to continue a more in-depth discussion with Mr. Aset Isyakeshev, who's the Minister for Investment and Development here in Kazakhstan. Welcome, Minister. Minister will give some introductory remarks, and then we will have a discussion.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I am indeed pleased to welcome you in Kazakhstan, the heart of Eurasia, a country of the great steppe. These days, most investors tend to take wait-and-see approach. They scrutinize prospects of entering new markets. However, I am confident you would share my view that the recent global developments offer both challenges and opportunities. I believe the summit is a valuable platform to explore investment opportunities and promising approaches to development of Kazakhstan. It will bring confidence to you in making fruitful business decisions. Dear guests, in the aftermath of the 2008-2009 crisis, the President of Kazakhstan, Nursultan Nazarbayev, declared a policy of industrialization and investment climate improvement. As a long-term objective, it has been divided into 5-year stages. At stage one, since 2010 until 2014, we were focused on development of infrastructure, transport, energy, communications, and industrial infrastructure. We have significantly developed our legislation and improved our investment and business climate. As a result of the first stage, today the basic needs in infrastructure have been mostly met. We have redesigned our economic legislation. We developed programs specifically for business to help them to increase their productivity, attract investments, new technologies, and promote non-oil exports. In fact, we started our policy of economic diversification. We made that decision that because in existed then economic model, the mining and oil and gas had made up to 20% of the GDP, while manufacturing had continued contracting. Within 5 years, by 2015, manufacturing had stabilized and now is secured at 10% of the GDP, while the mining sector had declined to 12% from 20%. As a result of these efforts, we created more than 2,000 manufacturers, 26 absolutely new sectors in manufacturing, and almost 200,000 new jobs. Now we have a new generation of businessmen, engineers, and scientists. And the foreign investors played a significant role in this process. Before the program, we had only commodity-based companies working in Kazakhstan: Total, Chevron, British Gas, Shell, and many others. After its commencement, the high-tech manufacturers launched their investment projects here. To name a few, the General Electric, Alstom, Airbus, Polpharma, Toyota. Only within these 6 years, 30 multinationals listed on the Forbes 2000s came to work in Kazakhstan, while our manufacturing sector attracted more than $20 billion. Probably they didn't know anything about this another 10 country, beyond, of course, oil and gas. But today we are happy to collaborate with all investors and will do everything to become a cozy and comfy home for their investments. Yes, today investors' interest in traditional raw material sector of Kazakhstan decreased, but the interest to the manufacturing is growing. We overcome the prevailing perception of Kazakhstan as a source of raw material alone and develop our potential of growing industrial economy with vast natural resources. Let me tell you about current developments. This year we moved to the second 5-year stage of industrialization. It's aimed to complete development of basic industries such as clusters of petrochemicals, fertilizers, production of high-quality metals and alloys. One of the key priorities is organic food. Another priority is machinery. With our rather small economy, our next area of interest is development of export-oriented manufacturing with high value-added component. We mainly target markets of Russia, Central Asia, Iran, and Western China. Besides the manufacturing sector, we are going to develop the productive services, which also will contribute the growth of the non-oil GDP and exports. It includes logistics in transit, new Silk Way connecting China, Europe and the Middle East, tourism, engineering and other professional services. We do realize that our journey will be tough without foreign investors. To address the new challenges, so-called new reality, last year, the President Nazarbayev has launched the plan of transformation and modernization of our country using the best international practices. The prevailing goal is to make Kazakhstan one of the top 30 most competitive countries by 2050. Kazakhstan 2050 is a nation's plan that envisages all the dimensions and goals of the social and economic development of our country. In the economic area, it is to diversify our economy, turn it to more sustainable and not dependent on oil. Prime Minister Masimov has already mentioned about this nation's plan and all strategic institutional reforms. From the perspective of investment attraction, our target is to make Kazakhstan an investment hub for the whole region in the middle term. There are large and rapidly growing markets around Kazakhstan. This is why we are focused on creating an appropriate environment and developing logistics to enable any investors to start business in Kazakhstan and access neighboring markets. This is to say Kazakhstan is a new investment destination in Eurasia. In order to facilitate investments, Kazakhstan encourages rule of law and stronger, more effective and more accountable governance. We cooperate with the OECD team to join the OECD Investment Committee next year. In 2012, OECD has developed 12 recommendations where to improve Kazakhstan's investment climate. We clearly know now our weaknesses and how to eliminate them. Kazakhstan already improved its legislation in such areas as private-public partnership, licenses and permits, foreign workforce, intellectual property rights, privatization, and many others. We are in the process of the mining reform. It is based on the Canadian and Australian models. To ensure favorable conditions for investors, Kazakhstan launched visa exemptions for 19 countries. Kazakhstan is working on capital market development, and in 2018, the Astana International Financial Center will kick off. I would like to emphasize that the financial center will be regulated based on the standards of the world-leading financial centers, as well as principles and rules of British commercial law. English will act as a working language for both correspondence and legal proceedings. Besides, since 2017, the Astana Financial Center will be visa-free for all the OECD member states. In this aspect, Kazakhstan is a pioneer in the CIS and Central Asia. We are planning to launch separate legal proceedings for investment disputes. In 2018, the International Arbitrage Center, based on the experience of Dubai, will be launched in Astana. Kazakhstan has launched a new privatization program aimed to attract investors into more than 60 large local companies, leading in the areas of electricity, infrastructure, telecommunications, and others. Many of those companies will be privatized through the Astana Financial Center. Under the President's Nurlu Jol program, which means Bright Way, for the investors' convenience, we continue incentive development of our transport and industrial infrastructure. Kazakhstan will turn into a regional transport and communication hub. We build highways, railroads, and seaport terminals. We invite investors to cooperate on the infrastructure projects through the privatization program and PPP mechanism. It is a big step towards a mutually beneficial partnership. Moreover, in order to attract investors into the priority sectors of our economy, we have designed a stimulus package which provides customs and tax incentives, subsidies and grants. Ladies and gentlemen, we have launched a proactive investment policy. In order to comply with the set goals, we have reorganized work of our ministry and other governmental agencies. Since 2016, the Ministry for Investments and Development has been working as a one-stop shop for investors. It's not simply a mechanism, it's a new philosophy. As a one-stop shop creates a single point of contact to provide investors with coordinated state support and cut red tape. We support investors from the entrance to Kazakhstan and until full implementation of the project. By order of our president, we implemented economization of Kazakhstan foreign missions. We selected 10 priority countries where 10 special counselors on investments will serve. Besides, we opened 5 foreign representative offices of our investment agency, Kazakhstan Invest, in New York, Dubai, Frankfurt, Istanbul, and Beijing. These agencies will provide full range of services to the whole region. They will render assistance in all paperwork, consult on every matter, matters such as investment location, partner selection, licenses, permits, if necessary. We are focused on starting assisting the investors at their homes. We coordinated more their work at the regions and cities level. The bottom line is that Kazakhstan is open for investors. To summarize what the one-stop shop is all about, we want to make it simple and attractive for you to set up a business here as possible. More than 500 investors have successfully used the one-stop shop since the beginning of this year. I believe our new approach will show its implications in the near future and we will see investment boom in Kazakhstan. We have been attentive to the investors community in Kazakhstan more than ever. The president himself chairs the Foreign Investors Council. The prime minister runs the Investment Climate Improvement Council. I serve as the investment ombudsman. These dialogue sites are designed to promptly solve all the issues the investors could face while in Kazakhstan. Dear guests, there are serious geoeconomic and technological challenges today. We are living in the world where everything changes in the blink of an eye. Robotics, life prolongation, digitalization, 3D printing, smart technologies. We witness the fourth industrial revolution being built upon the third. The lines between the physical, digital, biological, and other spheres is blurring, creating a fusion of technologies. We see startup remodeling economies. We talk about uberization, appliancization, and many otherizations. And all this development gives an opportunity to Kazakhstan to leapfrog the gap. We get ready to face these challenges. First, we realize how important human capital is. And therefore, we launched a new model of secondary, vocational, higher education based on the functional literacy. We have provided priority industries with qualified staff through training in accordance with the international standards. For this, we cooperate with global leading universities such as Cambridge, Oxford, and many, many others. Besides, we educate our future professionals at the best foreign schools under the president's program, Bolashak. Second, we're developing the program Digital Kazakhstan. It's based on modern digital infrastructure development. We will expand access to the internet with a broadband network, increase its capacity, create data centers and labs, and we aim to enhance digital literacy of our people. Third, we need to develop creative entrepreneurship. This year, we will begin a Startup Kazakhstan program in order to identify and support the best startups and innovators following the example of Startup Chile. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, I want to deliver a strong message that Kazakhstan is a reliable partner. I am determined that Kazakhstan will be one of the success stories in the nearest future. Kazakhstan will keep its commitments to economic growth, economy diversification and progress. With all these measures, we want to unleash the opportunities, the innovations, the growth. We have a clear way of developing, way of growth. Today you will receive a lot of information about Kazakhstan and opportunities it offers. I'm confident that some of the companies you will meet with and relationship you build will convert into real projects. Thank you for your attention.
Check a seat. Yeah. You mentioned the industrialization plan that Kazakhstan has, so that they aim to shift more of the economy away from mining and oil and gas sectors and into manufacturing in particular. What is the precise plan for achieving that? What kind of are you confident that transition is realistic for Kazakhstan?
Thank you, Simon, for your question. First of all, we clearly understand that diversification is not a quick win process. It's a long-term goal, which it take time, many efforts, and depends on many factors. Mm-hmm. So I think that our policy is ambitious as well as pragmatic and realistic. First 5 years gave us a very good experience. Now we have clear understanding of our industries, our business environment, our regions, our markets and goods which we can produce to become a part of global supply chain. Mm-hmm. We understand our advantages and disadvantages. We closely studied all global trends and risks. And we worked with our partners, World Bank, OECD, EBRD, McKinsey, BCG, and used their recommendations. Of course, when we designed this program, we took into consideration our external and internal challenges. Mm-hmm. In this respect, I think our program is should coordinate with many other policies. I mean monetary policy, education, infrastructure, business environment, and many other policies. And all issues which I mentioned will be addressed under the unified, the strategic plan of development until 2025. Government now is developing it, due account to the new challenges. By then, most indicators of non-oil share in the GDP and exports will see sustainable growth. I'm sure in this.
Okay. Many countries at the moment, particularly those in the oil sector, are embarking on diversification plans. Most countries in the Middle East are doing it. So the UAE or Qatar, even Saudi Arabia. Also, other countries in Asia, such as Malaysia, Indonesia, have quite strong diversification plans. In the face of so many other countries trying to do a similar thing, what do you think the biggest risks are for Kazakhstan? What are you worried about that might go wrong?
You mean for diversification?
Mm-hmm.
We studied experience of many countries, such as Korea, Malaysia, UAE. Now we... I think have a good model, balanced model, which should answer for many challenges. Mm-hmm. We understand our internal challenges, for example, low productivity of our many industries, competitiveness of our business, of our human capital, macroeconomic issues, and we understand external risks like economic situation in our main trade partners, China and Russia, situation of world commodity and financial markets. And as I mentioned, we coordinate our policy with other policies of the government because this policy of diversification should be should answer for these challenges. So we took some experience models from UAE. For example, from Canada and Australia, we took a model of mining sector, from civil aviation, from Great Britain experience, startup support program from Chile and Korea, Digital Kazakhstan from many countries, from China, Korea, and others, and working together with big multinational companies, technological companies, famous companies like McKinsey, BCG, with world financial organizations like World Bank, OECD. And I think now we have a balanced program of development, of diversification.
Okay. The drop in the oil price has obviously had a massive impact on Kazakhstan's economy, and investment this year is looking like it's going to actually be quite weak. I mean, in fact, investment might fall in Kazakhstan this year as compared to last year. What are your plans to overcome the downturn in investment that's come about because of the oil price?
Thank you. You're right. Last year we saw decrease in investment flows in many developing countries, including Kazakhstan. Also, I think it was a global trend. But if you look into the structure of the investment in Kazakhstan, you will see that decrease happened in the commodity-based industries, oil and gas and mining. But investments to priority manufacturing industries are rising. For example, FDI in petroleum refining increased by 80% last year, in food production by 30%, machinery saw sevenfold increase. If you take total FDI manufacturing amount, 70% of them came within last 5 years. It's more than $20 billion. So I think it's a good result for this current situation. But what about policy, investment policy at whole? I mentioned many issues in my speech, but I'd like to highlight main points. First of all, Kazakhstan is a market economy. We want to have a strong private sector and private investments. In this regards, we work in two dimensions. First, the most important and strategic goal is an investment climate improvement. We want to make Kazakhstan the best place for doing business in our macro region, not only Central Asia, I mean in macro region. We target to provide best investors protection, intellectual property protection, judicial system, effective bureaucracy. All these reforms included in our nation's plan, which mentioned Prime Minister. Second, we start proactive investment policy. We have a goal to bring $100 billion to our economy next 10 years. Today we have 40 billion portfolio and 200 projects with foreign investors. And we welcome all kinds of investors, multinational companies, small and medium investors from neighbor countries, financial investors, institutional investors in greenfield, brownfield, M&A and PPP projects. So I think our current investment strategy provides good opportunity to any investors.
Okay. I mean, thinking about the idea of encouraging investment in manufacturing, I mean, Kazakhstan has some challenges there. It's quite remote from a lot of the key markets, so transport costs are high. In a global scale, it's not a cheap place to do business, so it's not a low-cost manufacturer. So given those kind of challenges that Kazakhstan faces, what particular manufacturing sectors do you think are going to be more and less likely to be part of the future?
You're right. Transportation issues is very critical for Kazakhstan, for our development. And you know, Kazakhstan is a landlocked country, but also it's land-linked country. It bridges China, Russia, Central Asia, Iran, and other countries. Actually very important because two reasons. First, it will help to our business, our producers, to access to neighbor markets in terms of transportation cost. The second, it will promote multimodal transit between China, especially Western China, Europe, and Iran in the Gulf. For these purposes, we realizing program infrastructure called Nurlajol. We already invest $5 billion in transport infrastructure, and we will invest in $10 billion next 3 years. Our partners, EDB and EBRD, and etc. Besides, we are removing customs and other administrative barriers for transit. As a result, last year, Kazakhstan in the global competitive index jumped 30 positions and took 58th position among 140 countries. Let me give some examples of important infrastructural projects. We are building highway from China to Europe, which will enable cargo transportation between these parts just in 10 days. To compare, it takes 45 days to deliver cargo by sea. So it's very important project. We have completed a new railway between Kazakhstan and Iran. It's access to Gulf and Western India. Besides, we built a terminal at the Liaoyuan seaport in China. Now it's our terminal, and we are building new terminals in Iran, India, and other countries. We expanded capacity of Aktau seaport on Caspian Sea, and we launched a dry port Hargos on the boat with China. You can see massive construction of infrastructure in Kazakhstan, and this scale of construction we have not seen even in Soviet times. We have launched the first PPP in Kazakhstan project. It's ring road around Almaty. This project we are realizing with support in EBRD and IFC. But will be much more projects for PPP investors. I mean municipal infrastructure, railroad, airports, after roads, and logistics centers. We are convinced that the new PPP projects will be attractive for investors, so we say welcome once again to all investors investing in infrastructure.
Okay. I mean, alongside sort of hard industries like logistics, part of the global economy increasingly is knowledge-based industries, and innovation and R&D and technology are becoming more and more important. Do you think it's a possibility for Kazakhstan to get involved in those sectors, or is the focus more on logistics and manufacturing?
You mean which sectors?
What are your plans to get new technologies and research and development into Kazakhstan?
Innovations, it's a very hot topic in many countries as well as Kazakhstan. We understand that in order to survive in the future world, we should develop creative economy with creative human capital. This is only way. So we clearly see where we are now We understand which global trends, technological trends are coming. And our strategy consists of two levels. Level one is strategical. We should form a new generation of human resource for new economy. And the second is digitalization of our economy and social sectors. So these two directions are very important, and they will give effect in long-term perspective. But we should start right now, because it's they are very critical. The second level, it's innovations development in short-term and middle-term period. This direction includes two levels. First, we need to overcome a technology gap in our industries, basic industries, because they are very low level of productivity, energy efficiency, and efficiency. Mm-hmm. It's agriculture, mining, oil and gas, transport, and energy. And the second, new sectors development, ICT, new materials, smart technologies, new energy resources, and etc. Here, very important to work together with leading universities, leading technological companies, so-called game changers. Mm-hmm. And we shall make with them regional centers of competence. For example, we have signed an agreement with McKinsey to create competence center in mining. This project will allow to quickly introduce best world practices in our industry. Several high-tech companies like Google will participate in this unique center and introduce their latest products. I mean, Internet of Things, cloud technologies, and etc. Next year, we aim to launch the Center for New Materials and Additive Technologies together with McKinsey and several American and European companies in Almaty. Mm-hmm. One of the important things that one of Kazakhstan's most important objectives is to become a startup regional hub in post-Soviet space. For that, we have established two high-tech clusters, one in Astana, around Nazarbayev University, and the second in Almaty, in Park of Innovation Technologies. We realize to achieve our goals, we have to provide the best intellectual property protection, strong support of startup entrepreneurship, and talent attraction policy. We realize that development of high-tech industries is interlinked with the core competences. This we can achieve only investing in human capital, and we understand very clearly this, and this is our strategic goal, human capital development, next 10, 15 years. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Minister, for sharing your plans and bringing us in with your ideas for Kazakhstan's future. I think the audience will have been very interested to hear what might be coming down the pipeline for the next 5 years, and we'll have some more discussion on these topics. I know you're with us for some of the rest of the day as well, so I'm sure people will come up and have some more follow-up for you. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much.